didn't get to film science, which kind of sucked. Upstairs. I just feel like I'm gonna fall down the stairs. Gotta go to gym. So, okay, let's see. I couldn't film science.
I'm a unicorn!
I couldn't film gym.
I'm a flower!
Okay, then. Hey,
I'm a unicorn,
hey,
and a
you're flower. You're in the same gym class as Devin's weightlifting.
Yeah.
Torture him for me.
I'll call him Rocky.
Don't do that, he'll get pissed.
It's funny!
I don't care if it's funny!
Rocky, please!
Better not to ask. We're not looking for anyone. I'm here for food. So the girl, Helen, with the headband, that was my best friend who has the hot spot. Fine, be that way.
Tell me you like the meme.
Yeah. Okay then. We're gonna go get food. Jessica!
What?
Hi. Are you sure you don't want anything? You don't have any money? The best slash worst part of dreaming is that first 15 seconds after waking up, you frantically worry. What? What? I know, I started it!
Record the entire reaction.
Yo. I'm being mind-messed!
What?
She's messing with my head!
There's only one person in this world that can make me mind with it.
Yeah.
No. Ariana's brother,
Kaden. No. Yeah. I'm gonna go make fun of Ariana while she's in gym. We're amazing friends.
Holy! We're going to go make fun of our friend in gym!
Yeah, because why not? Tell him. Let's see. Can we see her? I don't see her. That concerns me.
She's probably in Mr. Mackey's class.
Oh, I think she is.
If she is. Oh yeah, this one was in.
I don't know.
This reminds me of stuff.
Okay.
Stuff.
Hey, I made fun of your boyfriend the entire time he was in weightlifting.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
I love you. Oh, I hope my boyfriend doesn't see your video.
Oh no, I'm sending it to him as soon as it goes live.
Oh god! Just tell him, don't listen to what Talon said.
Listen to everything Talon says very carefully and take it to offense.
Oh, please don't take it to offense.
All right.
Please, it's not that bad.
Mwah, I love you, girly.
Mwah, I love you too, girly.
We're gonna go upstairs now. If we can find our way. Okay, people are gone. So weird being in high school.
Either on the A or the B. So when you're on this text tool here, these two tools matter. The A, I can control the font. I've got tons of fonts I can use. I'm going to control the size. For right now, those are going to be the big things that we control. We'll learn other tools later. If I'm on the P for paragraph, I can center, I can flush right, I can put bullet points, there's all sorts of other things I can do. But for now, I'm on my text tool, I'm on the A, and I see my flashing cursor. I'm gonna put today's date, 9/24/18. I'm just gonna do it that way. If you wanna type out September, you're welcome to, okay? Everybody go ahead and do that real quick and then we're gonna do something else.
We also type out the day of the week.
No, I'm not gonna have it. Just
okay.
Daily papers do. How far down? Don't worry about where you put the text box. We're gonna move it into place later. As long as your text box goes from pink line to pink line, that's all I care about.
I apparently don't know how to
spell. So type the date. And I'm gonna zoom in pretty close. So you can, whoa, not that close. There we go. You see my date right there? Now to change the font, I want you to pick a font that's easy to read. And the best way to change fonts on here, if you're not sure what font to use, let me show you because it's actually kind of cool. So take a look at my screen real quick. You can type the date if you haven't yet in a second. With my text tool, and I can see eyeballs if they're up there or not. Turn, please. You're going to use this a lot. I'm going to highlight what I just typed. But then up in the upper left-hand corner, Minion Pro is the font. I'm also going to highlight the name of that. So when I have both of them highlighted, I will use the arrow on my keyboard and scroll through until I find a font that I really like. Everybody find a font. Please don't pick something so artsy-fartsy hard to read. Pick a nice font. Nothing too big and bold like Fred Flintstone, like the one you see on my screen right now.
Dang! Like ruining,
play with those fonts later. Just
ruining
nice,
my mojo over here.
Something you like. No wing bats, dippy, whatever they are. Wingdings, yeah.
Wingdings.
Well, what about word art?
This is Joker-Man,
ooh. I kind of want to
do some word art.
Yeah. Can we put it in Japanese?
Can I do this?
Can we put it in Japanese? You should be able to read that.
No, just pick a nice font.
Why?
This is a nice font.
To pick a font. 9.
Does it have to be in the same language?
6. I don't know. 5.
4. I put my teachers through a lot.
2. 1. Oh. Okay.
I literally just give up.
Now I'm going to zoom out just a titch. And I'm going to click off. Just going to click my arrow anywhere else. So that it's no longer highlighted.
All right. Do you want to
switch back to selection tool? Right now, you're probably in size 12.
Yep.
You make it size 14, please.
I don't know.
So
can
highlight it.
Can
go
I?
Go up to the top, and you should see 12 PT for 12 point. Now, you can click on the little arrow to the right and pull down to 14 because it's one of the preset sizes. Or just use the little baby arrows to the left and nudge it up 2 points to 14. Do it either way.
I feel like we should start using the teacher response. I don't know.
All right, you have the date. Make sure your flashing cursor has not been moved. It's right sitting right after your date.
You said
now everybody hit the space bar one time. Now everybody hit the tab one time. Space and tab. Now, you're still on your text tool. Go to the little P for paragraph in the upper left-hand corner. And if you look, it's the third one on the top, flush right. So you're on this one, go 2 to the right where it says align to the right. Click on align to the right, and your flashing cursor will be flush right, not what you just typed. That's why we hit space and tab.
Wait, like the paragraph styles?
Yep.
Okay.
Right here at the very top, see where I'm circling? Way up
at
the top.
Oh, okay.
The third one in is flush right. So now my flashing cursor, if I zoom out, you'll see that what I just typed is over here, but my flashing cursor is on the other side. Can you please put your name on the right-hand side?
I don't know, can I?
And it will be in the same font that you already have because we're in the same text box, but we're just flush right is all.
I don't know how to type today.
Now, once you have that, use your black arrow, click on your black arrow, and with your mouse or your arrow, I'm just going to use my arrow on my keyboard, I'm going to nudge that up so it's sitting right on top of the line. Not touching the line. I will zoom in really close. You will see it's not touching my line, but it's right on top of it. Do not do what you see right now. Put a bunch of space. So if I hit preview, you see that's weird. It's not right next to it. So make sure that that is sitting right on top of the line, but not touching it. It'll look nice. And if you zoom out, you'll be able to see that your name is on the right-hand side, not touching it. That's why you want to get in the habit of zooming in and out so that you can see how close things are. To the naked eye, sometimes you can't tell. But when you zoom in, you're like, oh, that's too far away. Yeah, Haley. Let it go across, that's okay. We're going to change color for people who have like J's and Y's and G's. All right. Next. Look at my screen right now. Now I'm going to zoom in just a little bit. You see how big my text box is? My text is only this big. But my text box goes down a lot further. So if I use my black arrow, I can see how big I can make this text box, but there's no reason for it to be that big. I want you to take your text box with your black arrow and make it just as big as it needs to be. And it'll make sense to you after we start putting a bunch of stuff on the page. Because if all of your text boxes are way too big, it gets really tough to select. Do you have a question, Alicia?
All you have to do is just imagine falling down there. I'm on the third floor.
Everybody go to File, Save.
File.
Go to File, Save. Now, can you please call it by your first and last name? And I'm putting 928 after my name. Beth Britton 928. So put your name in 928. Go into Stampede, you gotta go into Stampede, into the Intro to Journalism folder.
Why 928?
That's because that's the layout we're doing. I'm just gonna call it that for now.
Okay. Are we going into our student folder?
Go into your folder in Intro to Journalism. So go to your student folder and save it in your folder. I'm going into my Britton folder.
Weird. It's so awkward. I'm not sure.
So make sure you have saved it, please. Do not lose that article that I handed back to you. You are going to make the edits on that and place it on the page tomorrow. You can exit. Who's having trouble saving? Oh, okay. Okay, so let me show you guys really quick.
Wait, so we're done with it? We can leave?
Go to desktop.
I'm cool with leaving.
And go
I'm perfectly
to
fine with it.
And it's under Intro to Journalism in your student folder. Okay, so here, always go to desktop. And you're looking for this icon, Intro to Journalism, your student folder is in there. There you go, you're on the right track. One second. Did you find it? Did you already save it somewhere?
Yeah, I actually
already
saved it.
Oh, okay. Well, we'll go to desktop, and you're always looking for this one, with that little folder. Then go to intro, into your, click your folder, and save it in there. You guys, you two, whatever. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Can you get the lights for me, please?
Yeah. Was that leaf?
Yeah.
Oh.
That was the water.
I don't think it was.
Okay, yeah, that was go. I don't want to switch this. Algebra. We're off to algebra. It's so weird being here. It's almost like you don't really know what to do. So we're in English now.
YouTube.
what we're really doing while we're at school.
we're really on our phones. I don't know even how I'm passing this class. Okay, dude, my little brother watches this. Chill.
I want to... Trash is removed!
I hate this class so much. Get your pencil out of here.
Yeah.
In one word, describe school.
Awful.
No one's description is good other than Rachel.
Really?
So, everyone has either described it as hell, meh, bad, boring, awful, and we've only had one person say it was good.
Part of it's good.
I hate it.
I heard somebody say the school rules and the rules of prison are the exact same thing.
They are.
So we really are in prison.
Yeah, this is legit prison.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I gave her back her leg because I was tired of wearing it. It was, like, so annoying. I'll have to show you the clip from when I was in journalism.
It's funny.
Okay, guys. I will see you guys in drama.
Hey, this is a good class.
School, heading to the doctor's. Not looking forward to this. Let's go.
You're my third surgery, tonsil and adenoid surgery in a row.
Really?
Mm-hmm. So today must be tonsils and adenoid day.
That's what I'm thinking.
Sometimes it just goes in parts, though.
See, for me, it's the first day of homecoming week.
Oh, gosh.
That's why we can't do it this Thursday. Because I've got homecoming on Friday.
What school do you go to?
Let's see, Mark.
Okay.
We can't do it because Friday. Or this Thursday because I'm closing on the house.
Oh, that's right.
Has nothing to do with homecoming.
Oh, I wouldn't let us do it on Thursday.
Not about you.
Technically, it is about me because it's my surgery.
Oh my god.
I got shiz to do this Thursday.
And I got stuff to do on Friday. I don't want to miss it.
Oh, God. So, basically, the main thing, which will be on there, nothing to eat or drink after midnight, okay? I always do this to everybody. No smoking, no tobacco products, no suckers, no ice cubes, no water.
No gum.
Experiments, no nothing after nothing. Midnight. Yes. That is a huge thing.
Okay, what time is this getting done?
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
That was my next question. My next thing is, technically they gave me like the lineup the day before. Because Sometimes we have little kiddos that are like a year or 6 months old in tubes. So it'll probably be a mid-morning surgery, but I won't have that exact arrival time until the day before.
Okay.
Which is gonna, I know, the anticipation
so,
of it.
10 a.m.
Probably
10 a.m.
Oh, I'm okay with that.
Yeah. And yeah, so it's just
in.
Whatever you do not eat.
Sleep in and I'll be fine.
Yeah, and you can brush your teeth and stuff as normal too. Just try not to swallow the water though, okay? And of course you'll need a driver. And
hi,
that's
Mom.
Pretty much it. So,
hi, Grammy. How you doing?
God. And then I'm gonna book your post hospital follow up with Dr. Thomas. It's technically like 3 weeks out from the actual surgery date. Is your schedule pretty flexible? Or
yeah,
okay.
It's whatever.
Okay. All right. Let me just get on.
School.
So it is homecoming next week then, huh? Already?
For Great Falls High.
Great Falls High. Oh,
today's
that's where I graduated.
Today's CMR.
Yep, I did.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
Both of your kids are graduating from CMR.
And then my daughter graduated from CMR, but I was like, no, I'm a Great Falls High girl.
Both of her kids are gonna be graduating from CMR.
Yep. Yep.
You know those Bobcat Grizz blankets they make with the house divided?
Yep.
Why don't we have any?
I don't know. Exactly. I agree with you. I am totally with you on that one. Definitely, definitely. Is there any day that works better than others during the week, like a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday?
Thursday's fun.
They're pretty much.
He'll be in surgery.
Oh, he's in surgery, yeah.
They're pretty much all the same for us, I think. Well, for me.
Like Tuesday the 30th of October, the day before Halloween.
Sure.
Okay.
I don't do anything on Halloween anyway.
I do.
See, you're never too old to dress up.
Shush. Shush. When do you start driver's ed?
The 22nd.
The 22nd. So we need like early afternoon or late morning.
Okay. Yep. We can do the early second of the morning. It's like an 8:45. Is that gonna be too
early? That works.
Is that okay? And then I'll type that on this paper here.
Because then I can just stay home and not ride the bus. Because that bus sucks.
8:30, you said?
Uh-huh.
Yep.
8:30. And that way you're not missing driver's ed.
Oh my god, I am getting surgery done. Okay.
You literally...
You'll do good. You'll do fine.
You literally, you fall asleep and then you wake up someplace different.
And in pain.
What the fuck?
Yeah. How the hell did I end up here?
Because I don't remember.
Wait, where am I?
Yeah. And
wait.
It's amazing because honestly, I'm 43. I've had 14 surgeries.
Yeah.
Ooh. Medically necessary.
Dang.
Yeah. And it's amazing because like.
They better your life.
Well, they did, but it's just amazing how like quick they're like countdown from 10 to 1, and by the time you hit 9 or 8, you're already out. It's amazing.
Are you supposed to fight the anesthesia?
No.
No.
No. Nope. It'll just
happen.
It'll just happen.
Okay.
Just go to sleep. I don't even remember going into the
room. See, some people have told me that too. Like, they're in the bed and they're like, wheel them in the bed and they're like, I don't even remember going into the OR because I remember every time because I had to get up and hop up on the table. And,
yeah.
But some people honestly don't. So, okay. So I got everything in here for you guys. I just reiterated basically that nothing to eat or drink after midnight. You'll be the driver. Got your post-hospital follow-up date and time there. And then your surgery date, where it's going to take place at. And then my number is down here in case you have any questions.
Okay.
And otherwise, you are in there. And then we'll go ahead and submit that into TRICARE. Get that approved. You'll do just fine.
All right. Thank you.
Good. You are very welcome.
What's up? Welcome back. Day two of homecoming week, and I didn't go to school. Now, I'm going to set the camera up and do a quick sit-down video really quickly to explain why, but I want you guys to know that right now before I sit down and I'm like, yo, hey, this is what's up, this is my life right now. But, yeah. Okay, before I do my quick video, I'm literally just sitting up for this because I feel like death itself. This is how I'm set up. I have a pug as an armrest. And then I've got two Great Danes. Just, they are my legs right now. But me coughing, me saying I feel like death is not the real reason I stayed home. Okay, let me get adjusted a little bit more so I'm a little bit more comfortable for this, but, yeah. Okay, I think I'm good. I think I'm set up. Is that hair in my mouth? Okay. So, guys, the reason I'm staying home today is, I'm not sure if you could tell in the clips yesterday, especially the clip where I was leaving school, after I got out of drama class, what was the guy I was in a more forced relationship with, broke up with me. Now, while I was in this relationship with him, I did start to catch feelings for him, and I liked him, and that's why we were forced together. He had a very valid reason for it. And we were trying to be friends, but I caught really, really heavy feelings for him, and not gonna lie,
me being me, I could finally see something for, like, a future. I know this is going to sound really bad because I'm just a freshman, but I could see a future with him, and honestly, I still can, and it still kind of hurts, and I'm not really dealing with it the healthiest way possible, but I'm going to get there. I'm pretty sure by homecoming dance, it'll be better. If I go to homecoming dance, like, I have everything over here ready to go. I just don't know if I'm gonna go at this point. Fingers crossed that something happens throughout the week where I can just say, screw it, I'm going to homecoming. My friends are texting me telling me I'm going to homecoming right now. But yeah. That's why I'm not at school today. I'm gonna go edit all of these clips together. The clips from yesterday, the school trying to go to school clips, and then yeah, we're gonna see what we get from that. Okay, guys. Alrighty. Day 3 is underway. Today's theme is Cat in the Hat. I am not dressing out because I don't really care. I'm in a mood right now, but I'm ready for school, and my bus gets here in like 10-20 minutes, so yeah, I'm over prepped, but yeah, the clip from Monday where it was just kind of like my feet, guys, I'm really sorry I didn't explain that clip to you guys. That was me scheduling my surgery for my tonsil and adenoid removery. He will be removing the surgeon that is doing the surgery will be not only removing my tonsils but my adenoids as well, just because he's in there and it's a whole thing, but I'm getting those removed next Thursday. Hopefully I can get this video up by Saturday. I'm going to probably end up spending all night on Friday editing all these clips together. So, I'm gonna put the backpack on, and we're gonna go to school. Okay. How's the case? Alright. Let's go to school. Alright, I'm out of here. Love you too, bye.
Kiss my baby. Kiss my other baby. Are you gonna come in? Ooh, you are. Proud of you. And that's my third baby. Alright, babies. There's your new baby. I love you. Bye.
Leaving this house is like impossible with so many dogs.
Guys, if you can ever prevent it, don't go over 5 dogs. I think that's when we all lost our sanity and went, oh hey, let's get 9 more. Oh my god, we have 14 dogs. I need to update my animal list. Yes, I have a list of names of the animals that we have because I lose track. If I see them, I know it. But if I'm away and somebody's like, oh, what are your guys' dogs' names? I have to go through my list and read off my dog names. Same thing with cats. I know them all by name. When I'm looking at them, I know it. When I'm away from them, completely don't exist. Guys, before the bus gets here really quickly, I do want to have a really serious talk. I know I'm going to be smiling through most of it because I am not good with seriousness. I'm that one person in school who can never be serious. But the house that we have posted for sale is being sold on Friday. I guess I'm okay with it. I'm not really entirely sure how I feel yet. But it is a little harder than I thought it was going to be. Just having a really good memory of that house, it's a little difficult, but I know I'm going to get through it, and I know my parents are going to get through it as well. Well, my mom and my grandmother and my brother, we're all going to get through it. We're all going to be just fine, but yeah, serious talk over. Okay, so my neighbor that lives across the street from me walked out of their house. Okay, so I'm sitting out here playing music. As depressing as crap. And she just kind of looks at me and goes, "Are you okay? Damon, what are you doing?"
One's playing music. And then Gotham Go Bus is dancing to it. But it's kind of funny.
Should I show you what's on your way to? No!
Wait, yo, what? Yeah, Lane. No, don't show him. Wait, Hannah.
Is it asking him to homecoming?
Is it asking him to homecoming? Aww. Yo, I just got some serious tea. I'll try not to spill the tea. Look at that sunrise. Yo, I'm so sorry for the poor back camera quality. It is so bumpy on my bus. Oh, I got a text message. Look, this is my hometown, guys. It's really nothing much. I kind of don't like it. I wish I could have lived in a more interesting town. Look, there's a casino. Not sponsored. Unless they want to. I should go ask them if they want to sponsor me. Nah, I'm not gonna walk into a bar and like, "Hey, yo, you wanna, like, you know, sponsor my YouTube channel? It's family friendly." Okay. Getting to get to the middle school. It's my old middle school, you guys. There's going to be a lot of adventures on Friday. Friday might be its own separate video.
He's smart.
I could have been an honors. Honestly, I should be an honors.
I'm getting text messages. It's weird.
Yeah, me too.
Who's up already? Switch me up now.
Yo, it's so weird. It's kind of like being back at like a ghost or whatever. Look, guys, we're at my own middle school.
There's still construction going on.
Look at my middle school. Guys, it's so tiny compared to my school. And I thought high school was big. It's not. It really isn't.
We can all sit down for a minute.
Okay.
Everybody understand the rule about unoccupied seats?
Yes.
After we make that last pickup at Sun Loop, you can move across or forward, not back. Those of you who fail to keep the aisle clear will receive written notification about that. I'm tired of hollering back at people to keep their feet out of the aisle. I've been doing that since the start of school. So you will keep the aisle clear or you are going to be written up. One other thing, it's been mentioned about why can't my friend ride the bus? This bus is operated, as all buses, for the Great Falls Public School District. It is not your personal taxi. That's why you have assigned seats and assigned stops. Now, if you have a friend that wants to come out to your place, your parent or their parent or guardian has to call the Public School District Transportation Office. That's 268-6015. Ask for permission. Then they'll notify us that, yes, your friend can ride. Without that notification, it's not going to happen. Anybody got any questions? Yeah.
Can we go to school?
That That's because I didn't know everybody who was eligible to ride this bus then. Okay? I do now. Okay.
Jeez. Excuse me, that's my head. Don't mock me. Every time I see an officer, I will look at them and put my hands up and say it wasn't me. I'll also point to my friends and say they're over here.
Oh my god. Okay. My group chat just blew up to 68 messages. Why are they repainting the doors? Weren't the doors red?
Why are the doors red?
Because they're not. No, they're not red anymore. They're gray.
Nobody cares.
I care.
Oh, yeah?
Bus driver!
Can I
move
to this seat?
How
many of you guys are immortalized at that school? Do you not know what that means?
Can I move to seat 13 just for now?
Alright.
The doors brought you fame.
The second I walked in that door.
You know the
second I walked in those doors?
Like the apartment kind of
thing? It's not the door that makes you popular.
It's not the door that makes you popular. It's
you put it in the door and just
turn out on the guy who holds the door. By the way, for you at CMR, as you know, Friday is homecoming. The buses will be there for the early release.
Yeah, okay, we know that.
Who's going to homecoming?
Sadly. My friends are making me go. I don't even want to go.
I don't know who it is.
You going solo or?
I don't know. That's the thing, because I asked someone.
I'm just kidding. I'm
asking someone
today. Ask someone else. Bro, I want to ask someone.
Would you ask?
Cole, you're so optimistic.
No, not Olsen.
Cole. You're so optimistic.
Robin is going with Noah.
Yeah,
I'll be a slave.
I know that, boy.
No, he's like.
What's with the accent?
I don't know. I was really good at it. Come off it, mate. Fucking leave me alone.
Right. What do you think you're doing tonight?
What do you think you're doing, boy? I'll beat you like a snare drum.
What? I'm concerned.
I'll sound like a Shrek-in-y, man.
Shake yourself before you shrink yourself.
Really cool.
You about to get Shrek.
I can't
wait
for gym today, though.
Why aren't you doing
football? Because
he doesn't have
all the gym. I can't wait for coronation. You have to have
all the gym. Oh, that's tomorrow.
Yes. That is so gay.
Dress all three.
This whole fucking thing.
My dad got a concussion.
I know.
Yeah, no, you have to have health insurance to play.
I have health insurance.
Wait, really? I forgot I was recording. I'm gonna lose my mind by the end of the year, you guys. Just wait for it. We're prepping for the homecoming floats for our homecoming parade, and let's just say it has gone kind of to crack.
Look over there. Look how good they're.
There's so much going on right now. Look at there's so many good floats here.
And then you just see ours and we haven't even like got anything done.
Yeah. Dog, I forgot about that.
Do the booty jam, do the booty jam. Take okay. You out by the hand and do the booty jam.
Shut up. First of all, we just got done decorating floats. I did nothing. We're walking to a gas station now, I guess. Guys, which one are we going to? Gotcha.
No.
Frick, bro.
Hey.
Shanti, where are you going? Me. Legit me. Okay, can I walk?
Can I walk?
No.
Look what I'm holding on to. No, just wait.
Not until that one turns green and that one turns red.
No,
no,
it's shit.
Whoa!
Frick!
I don't even know what I'm getting.
Bro, I got no money. Okay, I got Talon and Ariana are back there along with Ashanti. John, your girlfriend's lonely. Dude. Love you!
Love you too.
Hey! Hey! John, tell your girlfriend you love her. Or not. What? You're an idiot. Okay. Hold on. Yo. Okay. Turn it down, Jesus, dude. Bro, I got no money, so I'm just gonna sit here. What's this about your legs? You should close them.
What?
She said something about her legs, so I said you should close them.
Dark in my room right now because I just woke up, but I don't want to be awake.
Maybe I can kick open the door a little more. Yeah, okay, that doesn't do a lot. Guys, it's Thursday, which means tomorrow is Friday, and I finally figured out how I'm editing these videos together. You guys are gonna see the leading up to homecoming week, and then Friday is gonna be its own separate video, including the sleepover afterwards, where, fingers crossed, me and my friends are gonna get the chance to play with a Ouija board. Now, we have done it before, and we play it responsibly. We don't make a joke out of it. It is a legitimate thing in our friend group. We will film us joining the Illuminati. Get the day started. Okay guys, so today is homecoming coronation day, so we're supposed to dress formally. So this is what I'm wearing. I'm wearing my black and white dress because I really don't care, and why not? Okay, and I am now wearing the dress, and the hanger got caught on the chair. Okay, put the ankle away here. So, yeah. I need to change out of my socks. I wear socks to bed because they keep my feet warm. And I don't like having my feet under the blankets. I just don't. I don't know why, but it drives me insane.
Go away.
The dogs are being annoying. Okay, so I have decided to show that I really don't care. I'm legit wearing boots. Ignore my legs, I really need to shoot. So, I don't really know how much time I have left. I have about half an hour, so I'm just gonna chill here and listen to music.
I put the mixer.
So, choir's done. Now we go to second period.
Yeah, we go to second period.
I wanna go to second period.
What?
I wanna go to second period.
Why don't you wanna go to second period?
Cause I wanna go home!
We'll save, but like...
Dude, I feel like crap right now. Yo, what are we doing in drama? Theater, whatever it is.
Two performances.
I'm gonna be one of them too. I don't wanna do a performance. Talon, if I end up doing a performance, can you record it for me?
Sure.
Oh, cool.
I'll record it.
What's up, Chris? I'm gonna try to.
Liz, all you have to do is give me your phone and I'll record it.
Exactly. Yo, at least you're not getting surgery and you're gonna be out of school for 2 to 3 weeks next week.
Yes,
Wait, you're gonna have to get your lungs removed?
Yeah.
No, I might have to have surgery on it, but the top part doesn't work.
Oh. Okay.
But we'll see.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm just excited to be out of here for 2 weeks.
Meow.
What?
You're gonna be
over here, meow. No one's noticing me.
I heard you meow.
I heard you meow. I'm ignoring you because it's normal. I'm over here just, which is sad.
I had a feeling it was normal.
It is normal.
The way she figures out where her boyfriend is they meow at each other.
Yeah.
Love you guys. Science. Coronation assembly.
It's so many people.
There's too many people here.
There's like
having
freshmen,
an anxiety attack.
Freshmen, sophomore, juniors, and
seniors.
And we have to make as much.
Somehow. I don't want to step over you. I have to lean on it.
Okay.
At least she's nice.
I don't like this.
Dude, we have to make so much noise for our own, like, thing. We are not gonna be able to do that.
I don't.
We have to make, like, a lot of noise.
And then there's these two over here.
Freaking being all cuddly while mine's in the freaking sophomore section.
Yeah, he's all the way over there.
No! No!
Emma!
My boyfriend's over there across from me.
You guys can climb over. Yo, you guys can climb through. We don't care.
Excuse us.
No, Nick, you don't have to. Excuse me. Sorry. Sorry.
Oh my God. There's like no space on these bleachers. Can I go home?
No.
Why?
Because you have to stay with me.
Says who?
Says me.
Why are they so cute and why can't I be like them?
Because your boyfriend's over there somewhere.
Can I go up and be a sophomore already?
No. And then there's Phoenix.
There's Phoenix right there.
Phoenix! Is deaf.
Phoenix? No. Phoenix just can't hear us apparently.
Because he's deaf.
Yeah.
Watch where Phoenix goes and you might see John. Might being the key word there.
Nope, he sat with his other friends.
Ta-da.
Hello.
He can sit on your lap.
Damn.
JJ, come over here. Kill me.
Nene!
Literally,
go!
Pretty together.
Yo, it's so hard to see on my camera.
Do you want me to do it on mine?
Nah, it's good, fam.
Liz.
We're vloggers now. It's okay, I just need the sound. See? You're gonna have to send me it. They get to be next to each other.
Yeah, well, Ben's not even here.
Thank you.
Look at the color of my cheeks. Okay, guys, so what's up? I'm wearing a different shirt. I'm actually wearing pants, you guys. I'm like really happy I get to be back in pants. I'm in sweatpants. It is 9 o'clock at night. I'm gonna pause that before I get copyrighted. You guys, I did forget to film the rest of the day. I'm really, really sorry. I know you guys saw some of the choir from orientation, and I actually had a lot of fun during orientation. It was really nice. It was really fun. I didn't present in drama today. I will hopefully, fingers crossed, be doing that tomorrow, and I will get that out with you guys. But that is where we're gonna end this video, guys. This is a 4-day video right here. This video was over 4 days. So, yeah. Guys, I really hope you guys enjoy my leading up to homecoming. My homecoming video will be coming out tomorrow, and it will be God knows how long. Guys, it's gonna be really long because we're gonna be walking to go see my old teachers, guys. That's gonna be really, really fun. We are also gonna go and do the barbecue to the parade. We're gonna go to the game, and then we're gonna go to the dance, guys. That's 5 different places plus school that I have to film, so 6 different places. Guys, I'm really, really excited to take you guys tomorrow. Hopefully I can non-stop record. Okay, my friend's texting me now. Guys, I really hope you guys enjoyed my leading up to homecoming video. And tomorrow, you guys will get to finally see what I'm wearing to homecoming. Hopefully I won't have to wear any makeup. I actually have to figure that out after I end this clip and get the video rolling. Guys, I'm writing an essay for my health teacher, guys. She told me not to, but I am doing it anyway. Guys, I hope you guys enjoy it. I love you guys. We're gonna figure out our motivational quote of the day, and we will be right back. Okay, guys, motivational quote of this video is, your future is not created by what you do today, or your future is created by what you do today, not tomorrow, guys. On that note, we're gonna end this video here. If you guys enjoyed, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, turn on post notifications to get notified every time I upload a video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed meeting the motivational family. I'm not really sure who all you met. Guys, I do apologize for the foul language in the video. Obviously, we're in high school. It's gonna happen. A few words are gonna slip here and there. If you guys don't know that already, yeah. Anyway, guys, I love you. I hope to see you guys in tomorrow's video. On top of the whole, like, 6 things I'm gonna be filming tomorrow, we also have a sleepover afterwards, so that's 7 things. 7? Yeah. 7. That's 7 things we have to film tomorrow, guys, and I'm really excited to bring that to you guys. Breathe. Guys, I will see you guys tomorrow. And until then, I love you. Bye!